Big breaking news coming in. Rajnikanth is not going to be joining politics. He's put out a tweet. He has cited health concerns. And as my colleague Akshita was mentioning earlier, this does not change much in the lay of the land as far as Tamil Nadu 2021 politics is concerned. And what are your reasons, Akshita, for saying that to us?
Essentially, because he's not going to be entering politics. So even if he was going to have any impact, even if he decided to delay the political plans a bit further, it would have been too little too late. But I just want to read out, Chethi, what he's put out in his statement. It's a very long statement where he's really poured his heart out and explained why he's decided not to go ahead and take the political plunge after all of these teasers that he's given us for the last 3 years, since 2017 to now 2020. In the three-page letter, he starts off talking about how he's had health concerns, talking about how crew members in his upcoming film, Anate, tested positive, then his BP went high, how he was told that because of his blood pressure problems, he could have a kidney ailment, and that's why his health was a concern. And he even says that he considers this as a warning from God, that this particular health issue, the fact that he was hospitalized just days before his announcement, it was supposed to happen on December 31st, he sees it as a warning from God. He says that I wouldn't have been able to campaign the way I want to on the field. I wouldn't be able to physically campaign. Campaigning through social media, through media, is simply not good enough. It would be a half-hearted attempt. I don't want to give a half-hearted attempt, and that's why I've chosen to come out of politics and not take the political plunge. He's also said, and he's apologized to his fans, saying, I'm very sorry that I'm not able to do what you desired from me. He says that, you know, when I spoke to my fans, they always said that my health is of utmost importance, and that's why I believe that right now I cannot go ahead and take this political plunge, cannot form my political party. Beyond that, he's also thanked everyone. He's thanked the people of Tamil Nadu, fans. He's thanked his aides, Manian, Tamil Nadu Manian, as well as Arjunamurthy. A lot of reactions are also coming in. I just want to read out S. Gurumurthy's reaction. He's put out a tweet, and the reason this is important is that Gurumurthy had met with Rajnikanth before he announced his political plunge. He said to have a key role in actually deciding what Rajnikanth's political ideology was, and also in convincing him to take the political plunge. So Gurumurthy has tweeted, and I quote, after Rajni health setback, he told me about his decision. It was inevitable. But read the penultimate para of his statement, saying without directly in politics, he will serve the people of Tamil Nadu. In my assessment, he will make a political impact on Tamil Nadu like in 1996. And I want to take that point across to Pramod. Pramod, you're getting us a lot of reactions from fans, a mix of frustration, of disappointment, also with concern for Rajnikanth's health. But when Gurumurthy says that Rajnikanth will make a political impact like in 1996, which we all know what happened then, does it even seem likely here? Because political parties were very, very tight-lipped. And Rajni, at this point, hasn't even made clear what spiritual politics means.
Well, like Gurumurthy is actually referring to the third page in that statement, and like, you know, second and the third lines of it. The first one actually says that Theerdal Arasilukku Varamal Makkalukkal Ennal Seyya Mudiyumo Adhu Naan Seivan, which means without entering electoral politics, whatever I can do for the people, I will do. And the second one is Naan Unmaiye Pesama Endrume Thayangadhillai, which means he has never hesitated from telling the truth. So this is what actually Gurumurthy is referring to, and he's claiming that so that way he still believes that Rajnikanth could go ahead and create an impact. But unfortunately, just like you mentioned, the fans are like, you know, starting to come over. They're standing out all the way over there. It was a little bit sad to see a couple of them teary-eyed, grown-up men, like, you know, with teary eyes over there, claiming that they were waiting for Rajnikanth, just like Rajnikanth said in 2017 as well, like the statement about system being correct and we need to change it. That's what he said. And even on 3rd December, he gave them a kind of hope, claiming that now or never. That was his one line. And the same thing is that Matruvom Yelati Matruvom, which means we have to change everything. Unfortunately, Rajnikanth gave all this hope and finally has decided to not enter politics, but it looks like he's only siding away from electoral politics, and that's what Gurumurthy is trying to emphasize here.
And also, Pramod, as far as Kamal Haasan is concerned, he sure looks like a more serious politician at this point of time compared to Rajnikanth, somebody who was trying to court Rajnikanth on the sidelines in the hope that there could be a third political front in Tamil Nadu.
Well, absolutely is. And Raj, Kamal Haasan will like constantly saying that he will actually initiate a third front. Like, I have to say again, there is no kind of like development about a third front in Tamil Nadu so far. But Kamal Haasan is believing it. But he was very careful about like commenting anything on Rajnikanth. He always took his time and said like, let's wait. And like, then only he will react. Three times this question was put forward about Rajnikanth initiating his party, for which he said, once he begins, let's talk on it. And like, Kamal Haasan also said that even if Rajnikanth wants to launch the party, he needs to actually give information about his ideology and then only I will react. That was Kamal Haasan's reaction. But later, when Rajnikanth was admitted to the hospital, he actually changed it and Kamal Haasan turned into a concerned person for Rajnikanth's health. And that's what he mentioned yesterday as well, that let him get well and then probably go ahead with the political party initiation and such. But he has always mentioned that their friendship is 4 decades old and anything, like nothing can come in between their friendship.
Okay, so clearly at this point, and I want to get a sense of really how fans are reacting. Prabodh, you've been getting us voices from the ground. We also spoke to Uma Shankar. He is a fan of Rajni. He too said that he is hopeful that Rajnikanth will go ahead and reconsider his decision. Very, very unlikely right now because Rajni has put out a very detailed statement. But this is what fans are saying.
Certainly not. It is not buckling under pressure from fans. It is not so. The idea of serving the people had been there inherent in him. It is not something which is rather got into him by somebody else. He is not somebody who will do things because someone else or some set of people, the fans, want him to do that. That is not the kind of person he is. He is an original person.
There you go. You heard Uma Shankar right there. Rajni's fan, one of the biggest fans of actor Rajnikanth, and he still hopes that Rajnikanth perhaps might change his decision and there might be a flip-flop again from a maybe to a yes to a no and perhaps a yes again on the part of Rajnikanth. That is how his fans are reacting. Fans are left disappointed at the moment. We got those reactions from Ground Zero. In fact, Pramodh also joined us just a little while ago getting us those reactions from the fans. I'm going to take this across to Pramodh now because he was with other fans of Rajnikanth right outside his house a little while back. Fans somewhere still hoping that Rajnikanth will at some point say yes. But, this is too much of a flip-flop for anybody. Here, it is not about Rajnikanth, but it's about anybody who wants to make a political foray after so much of back and forth, finally taking a decision, yes and then no. And now it's too much now for the fans to expect that he might change his mind yet again.
Well, you're definitely right about that because he gave high hopes to the fans. In fact, imagine the fans completely altering their, here you see one bike and this bike just simply say that, Archi Matram, RCL Matram, which means, change of governance, change of politics itself, and Ippa Ilana Yepo Mila, which means, now or never. And this line actually says, Vakalipir Makkal Talivarku, which means vote for the people's leader. So that's how they were reacting on it. And in fact, the moment he was announced that there was a rumor about a party called Makkal Seve Katchi, and that party actually getting the symbol of auto. This was confirmed by the EC earlier. Immediately the fans started actually using that as a symbol. So this word Namad Sinnam means our symbol, and auto became symbolic with that, and immediately they started working on it. Now remember, this RMM is not an organized party, but even after that, loyal fans of Rajnikanth were hoping a lot to actually go ahead and initiate it. But unfortunately, it seems like they have to either choose between Rajnikanth entering politics or his health. And even though it's a bit difficult, completely bitter for them, they have accepted it. And even though they are completely disappointed, they say whatever Rajnikanth has decided, they have to go with it.
So fans clearly are a very, very disappointed lot. And let's listen in. I want to really revisit what Rajnikanth had said earlier about his political plunge and the kind of intent that he really showed. This time, we really thought this was it. We really thought that now Rajnikanth is going to be launching his political party. 2 days before the deadline that he had issued, December 31st, he's come out and said that's not going to happen.
Hey, அது வந்து நான் ஒரு நான் ஒரு சின்ன கருவி தான் அது வந்து நான் நீங்க தான் ஜனங்க அழிய முடியும் நான் வந்து அழிச்சிருந்தேன் சொல்லிட்டு நான் வர்றேன் மாற்றம் நான் வந்த பிறகு நான் வெற்றி அடைஞ்சாலும் அது உங்களுடைய வெற்றி மக்களுடைய வெற்றி
All right, so Pramod Mahajan still continues to be with us. He's getting us all those reactions from ground zero as far as Rajnikant's final stance is concerned. Akshaya has been waiting for a while as well. Akshaya, Rajnikant going on to say that ailment is a sign of God, and many other political spokespersons that we spoke to, whether it is from the Congress party, whether it is from the AIA, DMK, all right, Akshaya will be joining us in just about a bit, taking this across to Pramod. All these political reactions that we're getting in on our channel, they've all said in unison just one thing, that it is a blessing in disguise as far as Rajnikant is concerned, that this has happened and he's not going to be joining politics. The Congress party has even gone to the extent of saying that he would have been desecrated had he entered politics. Now, whatever their political opinions are, and just like the way political analysts also say, not much is likely to change, but the ones who seem to be the most affected in this, one, the BJP, who was hoping as Rajnikant to be the face of their party for the upcoming 2021 political elections, and secondly is the fans who wanted to see the actor that they really looked up to fill up that leadership vacuum that Tamil Nadu was facing.
ஒரு அட்வைஸ் கொடுத்துட்டு இருப்பாங்க ஸோ அந்த டைம் டாக்டருங்க நீங்கள் எல்லாம் நீங்கள் செய்யலாம் கொள்ளலாம் சொல்லியிருக்கலாம் புரியுதுங்களா இப்போ வந்து அதை வந்து வேணாம்
To promote in just a bit, but also I just want to revisit what Gurumurthy has said, and this is a point perhaps will also be keenly tracked by Rajni fans, hoping that this means something. The fact that Gurumurthy has said that in his assessment Rajni will make a political impact on Tamil Nadu like in 1996. To jog your memories on what happened in 1996, Rajnikant had taken a very clear political stand against Jayalalitha and went ahead by ADMK that even gods can't save AIADMK. After that, we saw what happened in that election result. Is there a chance, Pramod, you're back with us, is there a chance, Pramod, of Rajni not launching his own political party, but making clear which party he backs in the assembly elections? And will that be the BJP?
Well, that's quite possible, because like immediately after he released his statement, we contacted the BJP camp, and this is where like, you know, the BJP camp also has to say that, like, you know, remember that statement, that three-page statement only talks about Rajnikant's actual retirement from, not even retirement, not entering electoral politics, but he has also mentioned, assured that like whatever he has to do for the people of Tamil Nadu, he would do so. So BJP still believes that like, you know, his support is going to be for BJP, and that is what also reiterated by S. Gurumurthy's tweet as well, claiming that how he'd like, you know, extended his support in 1996, but entirely for a different party and section, he's going to do it once again, and that will cause a lot of impact. But the question here is that, just like you earlier mentioned, he has been moving front and back, yes, no, and such. And everybody, the way he spoke, even the fiery speech on 3rd December, now or never. And finally, he has decided to do so, like, you know, not to enter politics at all. So these are questions that are currently being spent. How effective will his support be now? Is it like 1996, will it be that effective, or it's going to be much lesser? Those things are being debated currently.
Into a break, Pramod, there's one very important question right here is, whether or not Rajnikant is somebody who will still remain in the political fray in Tamil Nadu by providing outside support to a certain political party of his choice, whoever he aligns with. And that perhaps could be very crucial for that political party who was hoping to bank on Rajnikant's presence. Well, they will not get Rajnikant as the face of their party, but still perhaps would get outside support, whether it is for campaigns or for the groundwork ahead of the assembly polls, Pramod.
Well, that is quite possible. And the thing with Rajnikant is that he doesn't have to give a long speech. In fact, 2 days back, the Chief Minister, the Deputy Chief Minister, when they initiated the campaign, they spoke for 40 minutes each. But here, Rajnikant, just 3 minutes video, it still has an impact. He is Rajnikant. He is considered still as a superstar, respected, and there are a lot of loyal fans for him who actually listen to the words he says. So that's the reason that impact factor is still there. But what lines are you going to say, and how he's going to go ahead and, like, you know, extend support to which party, we need to wait and watch, because not just BJP, even AIADMK is expecting his support, and that's the reason. No matter how they are, like, you know, trying to react for Kamal Haasan, that kind of reaction you don't see for Rajinikanth. In fact, one of the AIADMK ministers called Rajinikanth as a brother, like hoping that he will extend the support to AIADMK. Yes, I mean, last week.
Absolutely. It's Pramod Mahajan getting us that perspective, and our reporters on ground tracking the story in much detail. I just want to say that there it is over, but perhaps still not over, because as Pramod was mentioning, if Rajni decides to give outside support to a certain political party of his particular choice, he would still be in the political fray, but from a distance, not actively engaged in contesting the election, but still perhaps could make his fans happy in that fashion, because the fans that we've been speaking to have been absolutely left disappointed with this decision of Rajinikanth. But it is his health concern. He says only he knows the pain. His health is not okay, and hence he has decided to take that final decision of not entering the political fray in Tamil Nadu.
Even if he comes out and speaks about exactly which way he stands politics-wise, this is going to be something that the people of Tamil Nadu are going to react very adversely to. The fact that now Rajinikanth has said, I am not entering politics, citing health issues. We'll be getting you the latest political reactions. So far, the BJP hasn't really come out with the reaction. Curiously, they've been tracking all the latest that's been coming in with regards to Rajni's statement. The DMK and the AIADMK, they didn't really react earlier as well, saying, let's wait and watch, let Rajni take the political plunge. So we'll be tracking that story very, very closely.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.